Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and this is the brand new MacBook Air. This has been a long time coming. A lot of people have wanted an upgraded one with a Retina display, so that's what we've got. Now let's take a look at the specs that I picked up. Now as you can see, it's the 13-inch, 13.3 inch, 2560 by 1600, 1.6 gigahertz dual core, but a turbo boost up to 3.6 gigahertz, 8 gigabytes of RAM, and 256 gigabytes of storage. This comes in at $1,399. Now keep in mind that price may seem a little bit steep, but if you're comparing it to something like the Surface Pro series, the Surface Pro 6, that's only $100 cheaper, and you don't get a keyboard with that one. And it's very similar specs, 8 gigs of RAM, same storage, although that does have expandable where this doesn't. Let's go ahead and open this up. And I picked this one up in space gray. Let me move this aside. I picked this one up in space gray, and we'll set that aside. And what you get here is USB-C to USB-C, like you'd expect. And then you've got a charger in the box. This one is a 30 watt charger. You could technically charge an iPhone fast charge with it. I guess I'm going to rip that to take it apart, but it's USB-C adapter. And then in here, we've got space gray stickers to match. And then we've got our information or literature. So let's set this aside and open this up and take a closer look. So let's go ahead and open this up. And before I open this, let's do a quick size comparison between the 12 and the 13-inch MacBook Pros. So we've got the 12-inch and 13-inch. So to give you an idea of size, the MacBook Air is here, the MacBook Pro's underneath, you'll see that in a moment. This is the 12-inch MacBook, and if you take a look at the sides, this is the MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, and MacBook. On the other side, we still get a headphone jack, but only the Pro gets the extra Thunderbolt ports. So let's set these aside and take a closer look at the Air. So we'll open it up here, and one thing this has that's really nice is we've got our fingerprint sensor here. It just turned on by itself. We've got a fingerprint sensor, the latest generation keyboard. Some people love it, some don't. I actually find that I can type pretty quickly on it due to the larger key space, and we have a larger trackpad compared to the old Air. So we'll wait for this to boot up and then we'll get it set up. Now after I set this up, I'm going to run a Cinebench and a Geekbench on it just to take a look and see what it's capable of based on just those numbers. That's not real world use necessarily, but it gives us an idea. Once we get past the network setup, we'll click continue. I'm not going to transfer anything from this Mac to another one or from another one to this one, so we'll set up the Apple ID. We have to agree to the terms. Click agree, select a password. It's going to set up iCloud, and that might take a moment. We can use the iCloud keychain. We'll do okay for that or click continue. We can set up Siri and everything else. We'll wait for it. Hey Siri is set up. I use that feature all the time. Turn on file default disk encryption. Just click on continue. And then we have Touch ID. So we set it up just like you'd expect. Click continue, and we can set up Apple Pay. We can do that later, and then you can pick light or dark mode. Then we'll click continue, and we should be at the desktop in just a moment. Now the keyboard is just like you'd think. It's the shallow travel keys, just like before, and they do have a little bit less noise than some of the older ones, but overall, it's not really much different. So if you're used to typing, saying one hand typing since I have the camera right here, but I think you get the idea of the sound. So it's pretty good, not terribly loud, but a different sound for a MacBook. The trackpad is nice and big, not as big as some of the others on other MacBook Pro models, but it's plenty big, especially if you're coming from a previous MacBook Air, and you can press anywhere on it for it to actually work. So since it's not actually moving, although it feels like it is, you can tap anywhere and you've got all this room to pinch and zoom or whatever you want to do. Now the battery inside of it should last about 10 hours. We'll have to see. It will take a while. And it's also more easily replaceable. It's modular this time around, according to Apple. Now, the MacBook is completely set up. I wanted to wait for all the background activity to stop to make sure the CPU wasn't doing anything. Initially, it had to sync a bunch of cloud documents and things. So now that that's all done, let's go ahead and run a Geekbench. It was a little bit warm and the fans were running at full speed, I think, before, but now it's nice and cool. I've given it time to cool down. So let's see what the benchmarks are. Now the Geekbench has finished. We've got 4,260 for the single core, 7,801 for multi-core. Now for most people, this isn't going to be something that they'll pay attention to on a MacBook Air. This is probably going to be used for school and a lot of people in college, but let's go ahead and run a Cinebench as well. So let's open that up and run that. Again, I'll give this a moment to cool down. So we should be ready to go. Let's go ahead and run a CPU benchmark and then we'll check out OpenGL as well. The CPU benchmark concluded and you'll see it's 254 and that puts it below a Core i7 as we would expect down here, but let's go ahead and run the OpenGL benchmark now. Now I can hear the fans running and it's not very loud at all. You could easily talk over it. It's not a droning noise or anything, so it's pretty quiet. So it looks like it just finished here. Let's take a look. We've got 33.13 frames per second, so it's pretty good. Let's do one more test and let's take a look at the actual disk speed. So let's go ahead and try the disk speed test and you'll see it's getting about 1,000 megabytes per second. Write speed, read speed is about 2100 megabytes per second. So about 1000 and 2000. That's pretty fast for an SSD. So not as fast as some others, but that's plenty for a MacBook Air. But let me know your thoughts about the new MacBook Air in the comments below. When I do a full review of this, is there anything specifically you'd like to see that you're not finding anywhere else? Let me know in the comments below and I'll see if I can do that as well. Oh, by the way, this screen looks fantastic. It may not go as bright as some of the others, but it's pretty bright. Overall, though, it's Apple's Retina display, which looks great. Again, let me know what you think in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.